How's it going? Have you ever wanted to design your own interior pages for KDP? Maybe you're making a no or low content journal and you want to design your own. Well, today I'm going to do just that. I'm going to show you using Canva, which is completely free, by the way. Make sure you sign up for a free account at canva.com. And before you begin to create a design, what you need to go and check is from KDP, Kindle Direct Publishing's website directly. Okay, don't listen to anyone, myself included. Make sure you check this out for yourself, because I don't want you to start doing your design and then realize actually it's the wrong size. Okay, that's something I've done many times. I don't want you to do that. So that's the first thing I wanna say. So over here, and I'll include a link in the description below. Okay. Under book formatting, format your Paperback Manuscript Templates. It actually shows you can download these blank templates if you want. But the critical bit for me is whether you select page without bleed. So this is without bleed, and this is with bleed. Okay, so bleed goes all the way to the end. I did a video previously, and I'll include a card on the video. Okay, somewhere you can click on that to have a watch. But I'm gonna assume today, just for example, we're gonna do a really basic KDP interior, and we're gonna go with the 6 by 9 inches page size without bleed. Okay, so assuming you've got that, create a design. As you can see, I've previously done one at 6 by 9. Click on that and it'll create this template for you. This is 6 by 9. Now, this is where it gets interesting. You can basically do anything you want. Well, almost anything you want when it comes to creating a low content journal. It very much depends on what your niche, or what you want to do for your niche. Okay, now you can do blank paper, but KDP has a limit, I believe, of 4 pages that are completely blank. So if you want to do a journal that's no content, so it's just blank paper, you can do that, but you need to include something within KDP's pages, okay? So you can't just have literally a blank page. You're gonna have to include something, you know, like a line or some kind of a squiggle or something somewhere, or even a border. Oh, incidentally, let me get the margins. I think we need to have the margins as well because that's quite important. Let me see where I can get that. So if you go to bleed trim size, here we go. Let me have a look. Okay, so this explains bleed in case you want to have a look. It's fine. Okay, here we go. Margins. Margins, that's the one I want. And they talk about inside gutter and outside margin. And there is so the inside of the page, so this is where the spine is. The spine has a 0.5 inches from the inside. So this is basically, if you flip open a book, this is your spine. And you need 0.5 away from the spine basically. And that's because if you do, you can see KDP is actually going to cut off some of this. So they explain to you exactly where they're going to cut that off. So this is where they detail how what kind of margin or inside margin size you need for. So if we're doing something from 24 pages to 150 pages, you need 0.375 for the inside gutter. So this is usually the larger gutter, and then the outside margin is typically just the same. So this is for no bleed. So this is for no bleed over here. You need 0.25 on the side. So if we look, oh, over here will be 0.25, and over here will be 0.5, so that you're in the safe zone. Okay. So if I'll just do a rectangle here, so you can see what I mean. So you've got a rectangle there, and can you see when I click on the rectangle, you'll see W2.4, and height 3.3. So width 2.4, you want that to go to, you know, maybe a bit lower. And then you can, and if you're having trouble zoom, you can zoom in. If you're having trouble seeing it, you can zoom in, and then you can actually play around with that as well. Okay, so for this example, I'm just going to keep it really simple. I'm just going to put 0.5 inches across the whole thing. So I'm just going to do, I'm going to assume we're going to have 150 pages. I'm going to do 0.5 across the whole thing, because then I know for sure that I am within the boundaries. Okay, so I'm going to set this to 0.5, okay, just for convenience. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to replicate that everywhere, top and bottom. All right, so I'm just going to Control C, Control V, and then I'm going to put that here. And don't forget, there's also the top. So if we rotate this to 90 degrees, we can shrink that down. That's fine if you want. Too far. Let's go back. Okay. So I'm going to stick that down here. Okay, so everything within this area here is going to get printed, all right? And you need to be cautious going on the edge too far. And if you want further details, I'll include this in the description, but basically you're looking at the inside, a minimum of 0.375 for 24 pages to 150 pages, and 0.25 on the outside, all right? So that's what I'm going to do. Oh, and they also cut the top, which is why I've included, I didn't need to include 0.5, I can probably do 0.25, but I'm just going to go with convenience here so that people can see. So instead of 0.5, you can actually do, well, this one goes to 0.3, that's okay. I've just gone with 0.5 because it's a bit more, it's a bit safer, essentially. So that's the lazy man way to do it, 0.5. That's what I've done over here. You don't have to, you can size that a bit better if you like, and then zoom out. So this is where your page, everything needs to be within the page over here. That's a safe zone. And if you're doing blank pages, you can't have more than four, I believe, blank pages. So you're going to use some kind of a squiggle, and you can get that from Canva's free bit, or you can import it yourself if you find something different. So I'm going to just, you know, for convenience, I'm just gonna use this. And make sure you check, you know, wherever you're getting your graphics from, that you've got the proper licenses. So make sure you check with Canva if you've got the proper license for this, that you can use it for your KDP or print on demand purposes. Okay, I personally like to get mine from Creative Fabrica, because they've got a really convenient license for me to use, basically. So there we go. You can actually stick this and repeat the pages, of course, to how many number of pages you want. So in my example, I might repeat this 150 pages or 151 pages. You can also do it just for 100 pages, whatever your niche expects, okay? And just repeat that. Of course, you probably want to remove the borders, okay? You can just remove the borders. So this is the simplest form of a no content book, effectively as a blank page, except you've got a little icon here, because KDP doesn't allow for completely blank pages, so you need to put something on the page. You can't just have a fully blank page, unfortunately. So you can size that however you want, and then there we go. Zoom out, repeat this page however many number of times you need, and then you just download it as a PDF. I think the free version has a limit. I'm not sure if it's 20 or 25 pages or 50 pages, but you can just use a PDF, combined PDF sort of software or program online, and just combine the PDFs multiple times until you get the number of pages you want. And over here, just download PDF standard prints or print. You can choose whichever one you feel like, and then you're good to go. So there we have it. The simplest way to get your own, create your own interiors. I've obviously stuck with something super basic, but it depends on your skill level, and I'm not going to make assumptions about how skillful you are, because you may be very, very accomplished, or you may not be accomplished at all. So this is the website I like to go to, Creative Fabrica. So if your skill level is not very good, you may want to check this out. So just type in KDP, for example, and then just see what they have. So they've got KDP interiors, or print templates, I don't know what that is, but effectively you can see what other people have done, and you know, you can just buy them. It's fairly inexpensive. I did a video as to whether Creative Fabrica is worth it or not. If you're using, you know, more than what the subscription plan is, then it probably is worth getting the subscription. But if you're only buying one or two, then it probably is not worth the subscription. So make sure you do that calculation yourself. Oh, incidentally, do not, like, this is my personal opinion. I would never just download these templates and stick it on KDP. I would never do that, because that means I haven't differentiated my work to anyone else's. So you might well find that someone else has just bought the same interior as you and stuck it on KDP. So I wouldn't want to do that. I would probably try and customize it slightly myself, regardless of what I do to customize it, you know. So that's just something to be aware of. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give me a like if you have, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And until the next video, I hope you have a great day. Take care, everyone.